See Big Brother Nigeria 2020. And Twitter reacted yesterday a whole lot. I think they are still reacting. Self, Lekor, Kidwire, Lucy, Nengi, V, and Tricky T are all up for eviction.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
And Erica won head of house.
Yes.
God of Erica was trending. It was trending. God of Erica.
I was very happy about that.
Yeah. Okay. So what do you think is going to happen? How do you feel about the nominations?
Well, I just I feel with this new twist that Big Brother is bringing into the whole game, but we never expected the people that went home last week. Okay, maybe we expected Watoni, but we did not expect Brightall. You know,
it's by votes now. Eh? Last week, eviction was by votes.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Like, Lord Bailey, she didn't expect him to leave.
We didn't expect... bottom for a while.
And what's her name? Tolani Badge, too, came as a surprise to many. Maybe the only person, not because she didn't play the game, right?
But
because...
Been, but she didn't get votes.
She's been there, severally. But the other two people, they've never been there. No, Tolani's been there, but not so much, you get. And it came as a surprise to many. So with this new twist, you know... funny enough, I was outside yesterday doing a vox pop on people predicting their winners for Big Brother Niger and what's it called now, and who they think, and if they think it's a negative influence and all of that. And a lot of people, after Sunday, had a lot of effect. They said, with the way things are right now, I can't predict a winner. Mm. Okay, I can tell you Prince today now, but by Sunday, Prince is out.
Yeah, I think if you were going to predict, I think it would be easier to predict the last four, not who winner. Will be winning the money. And
there's a lot of
twists and turns.
Yeah, and a lot of factors are considered on lock as well, so it's hard to be able to do that.
So what do you think about Kid and Nick?
I knew that Kid was going to be up for eviction because he's not the greatest communicator, especially when it comes to mass communication. Like, when he starts to talk to the masses, the way he can be a bit blunt. Someone said on Twitter that, oh, he's not rude, he's just rich. Sorry for yourself, he's rude, period. So I was very sure that he was going to be up for eviction.
I dare to differ.
But then, what's it called? The category of people that are there, I think it's now getting a lot easier to now tell who's going to go home, because I know Kid and Nengi are most likely safe. So
did you see where Kid was on the graphics last week?
No, but now that he's up for eviction,
okay,
and they're telling us effort, to save, right? Come on,
and besides, he's rich.
Yeah, so it's not like the money is the problem. There's no way.
At least I know Lekor is safe because he has. I don't know how Lekor he gathered those fans. I don't know what they see in him, but
V is not safe. He's safe. V's people have energy. Even though this week already, it's only Tuesday. They've been coming out to confess that yes, this baby is a bit too much because she's too much in her feelings. So I don't know if they're going to ramp.
She can't take what she dishes.
No, she really can't, and it's very pissing. And maybe Tricky T. Tricky T has been doing well too in terms of like gathering new fans.
I think he'll be going really home.
Improved. But I think he's going home. I think I'll put my money on V and Tricky T. But I'm
I won't put my money on anyone. But I dare to differ when it comes to what people are saying about Kid Wire that is very rude. I don't think it's rude.
You watch
rude.
The show? Are you sure you watch the show? Have you not seen the money on the head of house?
That you thought saw as rude?
You know what? A lot of people have problems with when you're in a position of power, and they think because you make certain decisions or because you feel like we're peers, I have to kiss your behind. Because
preach it.
Do you understand? Mm. I don't have to kiss your behind because we're peers. If I'm in a position of power, I would have to make some decisions that would not sit well with everyone. And it's okay.
This has nothing to do with decisions.
I'm coming. Hold on. And it's okay not to sit well with everyone. Mm. But at the same time, it's also okay for you to express yourself in the best way you think possible without caring whose guts is hurt or whose feelings is hurt. Sometimes you need to put people, but sometimes you also need to communicate certain things to people in a certain way for you to get into their ticks.
So you're not waiting, you're not even letting her answer my question. I mean, I just wanted to give one instance where the way he handled it or the way he spoke to someone.
There's too many, and I can't remember one particular thing now. Especially with paraphrasing his words, and I don't want to speak for him. But when he was head of house, I watched it because he was head of house with Erica, and I like Erica. And I was just noticing, okay, this guy, there's too many things. But I'm going to say this, though. First of all, Kidwire is not the first person to have been head of house, so he needs power. So if your excuse of being lousy with your mouth is because you have power, for me, that just, you in a way, you lack immaturity. I think there's more effort in being careful with making the necessary decisions to exude yourself with level of authority that doesn't have to be disrespectful, plain disrespectful. I don't think it was that bad, and a lot of them were quite insensitive, but I mean, a lot of them were quite sensitive, but he was a bit rude. And like I said,
if you're using the word rude and lousy for someone and saying that person has been that then a lot of the time,
Yeah. I said when he was head of house, 1 week, guys.
But you said it's
so
rude.
That was the only period that he was rude and lousy.
Listen, guys, it's rude too, right? No, listen, this is not even a personal opinion. I'm saying I'm not surprised that he's up for eviction because of what happened when he was head of house. Period. Okay.
Cool. This has nothing to do with wealth, if you ask me.
No, you said he's not rude, he's rich.
Okay.
Not say somebody on Twitter said he's not rude, he's rich.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm correcting that person. This has nothing to do with wealth. It's just a person's personal.
Okay, let's now turn the show to Tea Time Big Brother, right?